Hi, I'm Vince Hagen, Nordic Semiconductors, one of the business development managers, and I'm here to show you the LE Audio demo that we have at CES this year. What we're showing here is our LE Audio dev kit, which is this guy down here, going to be releasing fairly soon. So this is based on our 5340 chipset, and then we're doing the new LE Audio standard on this. There's two different demos here. So the first one is going to be the connected ISO. So this is connected isochronous streams, stereo streams over to two separate receivers. We got two of these audio DKs in this little box. They are both outputting different audio signals to the headphone. We've got them both wired to one headphone set just for ease of use. And then as we can listen to this, we can hear really good quality sound. The quality of the sound is based on the LC3 codec that's recently released from the Bluetooth SIG as well. So that's very, very good, and most customers are being pretty happy with it right now. We also, for our demo, we can show different features. So the first one everybody wants to know is kind of audio quality. So for that, we've been using a Dolby Atmos visualizer, which is a very good tool to show off audio. We can show that the stereo here, we can show a stream. Starts on this, we can actually see where the sounds are trying to locate, where they're coming from, in what direction. So this is really the blending of this stuff.
Right.
And then again, you can listen to it and it sounds very good. And you can hear it fading from left to right. The other way of looking at this demo, a lot of people are concerned about it, is going to be latency. So they want to know how fast can your signal get from your actual device up to your earbuds, so you don't have issues with like lip sync. Also gaming systems, they're very concerned about latency. So to do that, we use this audio video sync window here. This guy I can start, and what it's doing is it's just a YouTube video that actually shows the timing on this click. And then again, we can't show you on the listening, or we can't let you listen to it in the video, but as you listen to it, you can definitely hear that, you know, the clicks are very specifically timed on the right bounces. That's all down to us being below 30 milliseconds on lead time. So that is beating Bluetooth Classic right now. And most customers have all said that that's, you know, great. So very proud of this one for the CIS. And then the next one is gonna be BIS. So that's the other demo here. This was the CIS gateway. This is gonna be the BIS gateway. So this is now doing the broadcast isochronous streams. It's going to have two different streams coming out of it, and the listening devices can log into either one or can connect to either one. So it's gonna be, we're doing Spanish and English, as if it was going to be like a translation service. And then by clicking a button here, you can jump from English to Spanish and you can listen to the different channels. That can really come in handy in large conference centers or places where you're doing conventions and you've got a lot of people listening to maybe one speaker or one person giving a keynote. They can go ahead and they can, you know, have a translation service tied in there. It's also going to be impacting the airports, you know, bus stations, terminals, all the public transit areas where if you have your earbuds set up with BIS, you're going to be able to get your gate notifications, flight delays, those types of things. So that's very good. And then all this is, yeah, it's all built on the Bluetooth SIG's brand new LE Audio. So those specifications are steadily rolling out, and Nordic is making sure we support those all on our chipsets. So that covers both of the demos. And then if you want to know more about the Audio DK or our software solution or LE Audio specifications and when they're going to be rolling out, you can visit our webpage. Looks like this. So we're constantly updating this webpage as we get more information and as we release new portions of the code into our SDK system. So that's really the main point to start jumping on this technology.